Hey, and welcome to another video in our Hikvision Video Intercom series. So, we're coming to the end of our series now, and we're basically just going to be showing you how to use iVMS a little bit, and now we've got our system configured, how we'll be able to add users, add more fobs and car keys, and we'll be able to see a few history logs, just in case something happens, I don't know, something goes missing, a break-in, and you want to see who's been accessing the system. Okay, so we'll be using IVMS for this. If you don't know how to use it, we have got another video on how to set this up. I advise you to check that out. And how to update the fobs and cards, we have another video how to set that up. I advise you to watch that because we're only going to be briefly going through that. Okay, so let's show you first of all how to edit the users, just in case you need to change the fobs and things. And then we'll go to see the history logs. Okay, so let's just go into IVMS. Okay, we're into IVMS right now. Okay, so as you see here, we've got our person, okay, and we've got our three people we've been using. Okay, so let's say, for example, John, we want to edit the user. Okay, so from here, you can just change the telephone number, email, all that stuff. You can see the cards he's using, the numbers, and all the additional information that we've set up, okay? So it's not doubtful that it would change the room or whatever, but some information does change. Okay, and so we want to add a new card, a new fob, so we go add the plus here. Make sure we go to the card reader. It's all set up for the door station. Perfect, so we go read, and then you put your fob to your card reader. Okay, and it should write one. Okay, there, I just bibbed one in, and we can add that. So John's now got a third card, and we go okay. Okay, great. So you can do the same obviously with other users, and you can do the same, you can add a user, just fill in the details, remember to assign the group. Okay, so we got our same household, same flat hold, and then you just bind the device whatever flat number, screen number it is. Okay, and then you just put in the appropriate details. Okay, so it's pretty easy to update and edit the users and delete fobs and add fobs. What we're going to do now is show you quickly how to see if anyone's accessed the building with fobs. Okay, so we go back to our main menu here and we go to Event Center. So, okay, real-time events. Okay, this is more to do with motion detection and things like that. You can set that up for your camera. We're not talking about it today. We're going to go to Event Search. Okay, so we're in our event search and we're in our door station, so which is our main door station, which we want to see what's going on. And today we're just going to see what's going on today. So we go search, haven't really used it today. Okay, so there was an invalid card event just taken out. Okay, because I was messing around. So what we're going to do, I've got a few fobs and cards, I'm just going to add them now and then we're going to do another search. Okay, we'll not add them, just to log into the system. Great. So we had one invalid card swipe and we had two legitimate ones. So let's do another search. Okay, now we see three more come up. So we had an invalid card swipe. That means I was using a card that was not associated with that. I did that on purpose. And we had two normal ones. So we go here and we even get a screenshot of me doing that. Okay, isn't that handy? Yeah. Okay, so if you do want to see who goes in, you can see if it's the actual person or if it's just someone you just don't know. So a very handy little feature here. And the last thing we're going to go over is the main admin user history log. So we go to our main view and we're not over here, we go to system log. Okay, so we're on system log. This is today, we'll just do a quick search for today. And this is me and this is all the things I've been doing. Okay, I deleted some users, we were messing around with it. Added to the person as we just saw now, and I did an event search. So if you wondered if someone's accidentally logged into your system or you're worried about the security, go to the system log here and you'll be able to see all the history of what people have done just in case they've done and messed something up. Okay, so that's more or less your basic training for IVMS 4200. There's a lot of videos around on eBay. You can obviously look through the settings here and set up different things. Feel free to have a look. Before we go, we're just going to do one more thing, and this is quite important if you're worried about if you've got lots of users. What you can do is click on the users here and you can go export. So what it'll do is export your chosen your history, all the information, all your IDs, FOB numbers and everything like that. So just in case you lose all this information, I recommend exporting it and backing up frequently. Okay, so I hope you guys learn a bit more familiar now with IVMS, and this draws an end to our series, unfortunately. So I hope you guys learn how to set up a system, or you just watching this and found it interesting. It's been a long process here. So I hope if you've watched all the videos, I'd like to say a big thanks for sticking through it. And yeah, just so if you're, like I said, if you've enjoyed it, please subscribe. Please feel free to leave a comment. And if you are interested in the system, just get in contact with us and we'll be happy to sell you, because we know the system works. We've proven it here and we have a lot of faith in it. So hopefully you see you guys on another video, or if you get in touch with us, that'll be even better. Thanks and see you again. Bye.